Hey everyone, it's been 1 year since we released the Eternabond modification video, and I want to give you guys an update on how it's held up. Before we go up on the roof and take a look at everything, I do want to answer a couple questions and comments since the original video was released 1 year ago. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put a link at the top of the screen right now so you can check that out. I recommend watching that video first so you understand the content of this video. The first thing I want to mention is that this modification was not my original idea. People have been using Eternabond to seal their roof years before we released our original video. After releasing our first video, we received a lot of comments from viewers who have done this modification and said that it's still holding up years later. There's also other YouTube content creators who have also done this modification and made a video about it, some that you may already have watched. Remember, I have no affiliation with Eternabond. They didn't supply the materials or sponsor my original video. I only decided to perform this modification after doing a little bit of research. Which leads me to the second point. I did a lot of research before performing this modification. Eternabond carries a 15-year warranty. It's waterproof. And some RV manufacturers use this to seal RV roofs from the factory, and that's probably why this modification grew legs. Eternabond is made by HB Fuller. I'll put a link to their website down below in the video description if you want to go ahead and check them out. Third, and probably the most important thing I want to mention, is that proper application of Eternabond roof seal is key to the success of this modification. If your current lap sealant is cracking, peeling, or lifting, you need to remove it and reseal before you lay down the Eternabond. If you do have to lay down new lap sealant, I would suggest letting it cure for 30 to 60 days before applying the Eternabond. It's also important that you lay this Eternabond down flat without wrinkles and use a lot of pressure to activate the adhesive. Now you can use a roller to apply the pressure. I just used my thumb because I thought I could apply more pressure using my thumb. Now using your thumb does take a lot longer, but it's what has always worked for me. There's also been some comments from viewers who have already used Eternabond in patching applications and had mentioned this stuff is pretty difficult to get off, which leads to the question of what are you supposed to do if you have to replace, for example, a skylight that is sealed with Eternabond? So yes, it is difficult to get off. I'm not gonna say that it's not, but that is the trade-off. If this stuff didn't stick so well, this wouldn't be a modification and this video would not exist. So of course it's not easy to get off. Is it impossible to get off? No, absolutely not. I'll address replacement of a component that is sealed with Eternabond a little bit later in the video. Also, at the end of this video, I'll discuss if there's anything I would have done differently the first time around, and I'll give you my honest opinion on whether or not I still stand behind this modification. So let's go topside and see how this modification has held up. Okay, so one thing you'll notice, and I'll put a shot up on the screen right now, is sometimes on the edges of where lap sealant is applied, you'll see the roof membrane slightly pull up. It's not unusual for TPO membranes to lift a little bit where lap sealant is applied. As long as it doesn't continue to spread, you're fine. The reason I mention this, it may look like the Eternabond over it is actually what's lifting, but you can see here in the areas where the TPO lifts, the Eternabond is still sticking to the membrane. So this next piece I want to show you is the Eternabond over the sealant on the skylight. As you can see, the edges are solid and the Eternabond over the sealant is held up perfectly. This is the other side of the skylight. Okay, so this is the back of the trailer, and as you can see, this Eternabond is still secure all the way around. It's tight against where the sealant is. And I know some people say this stuff will fail, but guys, I'm not seeing any type of evidence that this is failing, lifting, cracking, not seeing any type of UV damage either. And remember, this hasn't been cleaned yet. So I'm gonna clean my roof and show you guys what everything looks like cleaned up too. No lifting whatsoever. And the sealant underneath is still solid. And you could actually put Eternabond over Eternabond, so you can overlap this product as well. So moving up to the front cap, now you're gonna see a couple wrinkles here, but guys, that's my fault. I didn't get this stuff on perfectly straight. But if you press with a roller or your thumb where there's wrinkles, the adhesive underneath the top coat of the Eternabond will settle onto the membrane and stick. Here's another example of where it looks like the Eternabond is lifting, but it's actually stuck to the membrane, which is lifting, which again is normal around where you have sealant. This is the side of the trailer, and as you can see, if you get this stuff on flat, it's gonna stick. There is no evidence of bubbling, movement, cracking, peeling. This is the other side of the camper. I think everything looks great. Looks like it was applied a couple days ago. Again, it is a little dirty, and I'm gonna clean this up so you guys can see what it looks like on a clean roof. Any dirt on this tape comes off with just a little bit of moisture. I know it's dirty up there, but I thought it was important to show you guys what it looked like after being untouched for a while. Stick around to the end of the video. We'll go back up on the roof after it has been washed, and I think you'll be surprised how well everything cleans up. In the meantime, would I have done anything differently? Probably not. I have painted a few cars in my day, so I was pretty meticulous with cleaning and drying the surface before applying the Eternabond. However, we got some comments from viewers who have done this modification and made some good suggestions, so I want to share those with you guys today. One viewer had mentioned that after they cleaned the area, they applied some rubbing alcohol to the area where they were going to apply the Eternabond and wiped it off with a soft towel. Acetone is another cleaner that a few people mentioned as well. Even though I had no issues with the Eternabond sticking, I think this is a good suggestion as alcohol will clean up any residue left behind from your soap and it will evaporate quickly. Now, Eternabond has their own branded cleaner. It's essentially acetone in a can. They also make a primer that is recommended for applications on rough surfaces. Again, I didn't use either of these products because I have experience using Eternabond on the surfaces we're talking about today and never had any issues with it sticking, but they are available if you want to use them. Another viewer comment mentioned that they applied lap sealant to the edge of the Eternabond tape, and I think this idea is fine too. If in the rare case water is going to get underneath the Eternabond, it's going to happen at the edge. Now, the purpose of this mod is so you're not having to reseal every year, but a small bead of lap sealant along the edge of the Eternabond tape, despite still needing to be resealed every so often, is going to take much less time and material than resealing your whole roof. So that's an option too. It's definitely function over form, but again, the idea is to remove the oxygen, the elements, and the UV rays from the lap sealant, which is what breaks down the lap sealant over time. On top of that, you're adding another layer of waterproof protection. You can, however, apply a roof sealer over the Eternabond, something like RV Armor, over the entire roof once you're done installing the Eternabond if you want to get that cleaner look. I'd make sure the roof seal you're going to use will stick to the Eternabond, and most should, but that is definitely an option as well too. So earlier I mentioned removing a component that is sealed with Eternabond, and if you want to do this without having to remove the entire Eternabond, I would just cut the Eternabond right where the lap sealant meets the membrane of the roof. Then you could remove the component and the lap sealant as you normally would using a razor knife or a scraper, then install your new component, lay down your new lap sealant, and apply Eternabond on the new lap sealant right over to the existing Eternabond already on the membrane. Now, if you want to remove Eternabond, there's a lot of different videos that you'll find. Most will recommend using a heat gun and a scraper. Again, it's a little time consuming, but that's the trade-off when you're using a waterproof tape. But the interesting thing I found was an 11 or 12 year old video from the Eternabond company. I'll put a link to that video down below in the video description. The video mentions to get as much of the micro sealant or the glue on the bottom of the Eternabond tape off as possible using a cleaner like acetone. But they also suggest you can put new Eternabond right over the old micro sealant as it will fuse together. They also mentioned to use their primer spray in this type of application because the primer is meant for rough surfaces. And I'd agree that this is definitely the type of application where the primer should be used. These are all things to consider before giving this modification the green light. It's ultimately your decision to pull the trigger on specific products or modifications based on what's best for you. Remember, our purpose here is to show you what's out there in the RV universe, the products that are available, the modifications that we have done, and to share those experiences with you guys, good or indifferent. So, finally, do I still stand behind this modification? Absolutely, I do. Cleaning, prepping, and careful installation are the keys to the success of this modification. If I didn't stand behind it, I wouldn't have done it to my RV, and will continue to post an annual update video of how the Eternabond is holding up. We're about to go back up on the roof to show you what everything looks like cleaned up, but if you enjoyed the video, we hope you consider hitting that like button down below and subscribing to the channel. And as always, we appreciate all your support. All right, as promised, let's get back on the roof and check out the Eternabond mod 1 year later after a nice roof cleaning.